Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Ignace, Aleya, and I hope you enjoyed that little intro. In today's video tutorial, I will be showing you how to create a realistic looking hover effect in Adobe After Effects, just like in the example. But first, let me break down what I've actually done before I started recording. So I actually recorded the last shot first because there I needed my wheels on the skateboard. I just drove through my street and recorded myself that way, and I made sure that I also had a clean plate of that street. Then next, I took off the wheels of the skateboard, but in this case it was actually really, really hard because it's actually a really old skateboard and the screws were completely rusted. So taking them off was really hard. And of course, like in every story, the first 7 screws were super easy to take off. And that last 1 screw, I think I spent an hour trying to get it off. It completely broke and I couldn't get it off, but finally I did. So yeah, what an intense moment that was. Anyway, so then I ended up using some practical effects in order to do that hover effect on the floor, because that's really hard to do with visual effects. So I went for a simpler option, which is actually using fishing wire. I took some fishing wire, put that through the holes, and then I dropped the skateboard trying to balance it and looking like a hoverboard. I tried that a few times because it wasn't easy to do. So just try to balance it right and to make it look realistic like a real hoverboard. And then with some simple wire removal techniques, I removed that wire. So that's not what we're going to be seeing in today's video, as it's actually more practical effects than visual effects. In today's video, I will be showing you how to hover through your street like in the last shot. So like in every video, if you want to follow along using the exact same footage as me, I will provide a link in the description below where you can download the exact same footage so you can follow along with this tutorial. If you enjoy watching my videos, be sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so you stay notified when I upload new videos. And apart from that, let's jump into Adobe After Effects and get started. Alright, here we are in Adobe After Effects. The first thing that I'll do is import my footage into a new sequence. And there we go. So as you can see, I'm driving the skateboard through the street right here. It's actually quite a tricky shot because of the shadow, and we're gonna have to correct the shadow right here because you see the wheels in the shadow, which we'll have to cut out. So if you have the option to film yourself during a cloudy day, that's usually gonna get an easier result to achieve. So in this case, I took it a little bit harder to see what I could come up with, and yeah, let's go. Click on the original footage and go to the end until we see a clean plate of our shot. Now we want to duplicate this by going to edit, duplicate, and then right click, time, and freeze the frame. Now we have a frozen frame, which is going to act as a clean plate to key out the wheels of the skateboard. The first thing that I've done is right click and create a new solid layer, and this is going to be my alpha mat. I want to disable this solid layer, and then I want to go to the pen tool and zoom in here to my skateboard. I want to drag a kind of mask just so the top of the skateboard is still visible, and just mask around the wheels like that. And then before we make a keyframe, what we want to do is go here to the mask feather tool. And this is actually a really cool tool to kind of dial in the feather around this mask. So right here we want a little bit of feather because we're just underneath the skateboard, but right here we do want a little bit more feather so it actually transitions better with the clean plate. So I'm going to click over here, drag it down just a little bit. Click over here, also drag it down just a little bit. But then once you're here, you can really bring this in and kind of get it looking like that. And there we go. So now we have a nice transition from a kind of harder feather into a softer feather right here. So I'm going to bring this in even more if I can. And there we go. Now click on the stopwatch to create a keyframe and then move back and move this entire mask just underneath the skateboard. We're going to do this manually because the tracking doesn't work very well in this case, but it's also pretty easy to do manually, so that's not a big problem. And then just move it, maybe even make it a little bit smaller to fit the actual skateboard here. Like that. And then just check in between these keyframes if everything looks all right, because the skateboard is moving a little bit, but that seems about right. And then once you're done, just enable this layer again so you can actually see what's going on here, and then enable the frozen frame as well, and then just click here, alpha mat, and that's going to look at that mask
and make a mask out of that. I'm going to make this yellow so we can actually see. This is the roto of the clean plate, and there we see how it's looking here. So the shadows are a little bit feathered out, and that looks all right. So the next thing that we want to do is add some shadow below the skateboard, because we want to kind of give that impression of depth and of height. So I'm going to right click new, and I'm going to make a new solid layer shadow, and then just click with the pivot tool in one of the shadow areas here and click OK. Then disable this for now, and then go into the with the pen tool and draw a kind of shadow mask around the bottom of the skateboard on the floor, something like this. Maybe move it a little bit to get the perspective going right, and then enable this layer, press F on the keyboard, and kind of feather it a little bit like so. But maybe you can also open up the mask options and decrease the expansion so it's kind of subtle, and we have something like that. So this looks pretty cool. I'm going to make a keyframe for the mask path, and then go to the beginning of the shot and move this mask over to with the skateboard, and also make it smaller because we're actually further in space. Move it over a little bit, and then move and check and get it back in position each time. And then all the way at the end of the shot, we want to move it all the way till the end, but also make it quite a little bit bigger. And there we go. And that shadow is already gonna do quite a lot. So if we're going to check now at the preview, we do see that shadow below our skateboard, and that just looks a lot better in my opinion. We can also increase the feather a little bit more so it's kind of softer, but it's looking pretty good. If you think it's a little bit too strong, you can also press T on the keyboard and lower the opacity here to something like 50 and get it very subtle. And then lastly, what we want to do is recreate that shadow here in the background, because the original shadow is actually with the tires and we want to key these out. So we want to recreate the shadow. So in order to do that, I'm going to do some basic rotoscoping, but instead of rotoscoping a person, I'm going to be rotoscoping the shadow. So what I'll do is right click new, and I'm going to make a new solid layer, rename this hard shadows, and uncheck this for now. And now I'm going to the pen tool and kind of make a simple mask around the shadow here. And there we go. And then press M on the keyboard and click on the stopwatch again to make a keyframe. Move back and move this mask right here. So this is actually just to cover the small space where the sun is shining here. Right here we don't see any shadows, so there we don't have to keyframe anything. Just want to get this out of the shot and then move in and readjust it and kind of keyframe it into position. So readjust where needed and let's go. And that's looking pretty cool. I think we're there. So once you're done, now we want to enable this layer again so we can actually see it and unsolo the original footage. So we have our shadow here in the background. It's a little bit too hard, so what I'll do is press M twice on the keyboard or open up the mask settings here and feather it like 5 pixels, but also remove some mask expansion like -2. Then maybe 5 is a little bit too much, like 3. And if I uncheck and enable, it kind of matches the original shadow quite good. We can also click on the layer and go to layer solid settings and use the pivot tool again to really get that exact color here, and then click OK. And we have some shadows here, which is looking pretty cool. And then right here, just before it ends, I'm going to press T on the keyboard and click on the stopwatch for the opacity. Move forward a little bit until we're out of the shot, and then just zero out the opacity so it kind of fades out here because we don't have any shadow here. And then right here at the beginning, I'm going to do the same thing. Right here, I want it at 100%. Click for a new keyframe. Move back and zero out the opacity, and then we have something like that. And then lastly, what I've done in Premiere Pro is use one of our presets, this TC camera shake preset, which you know I like to use a lot. And at the end here, what I've done is just applied a medium shot version 1 here. And as you can see, it's adding some shake to the camera and making the scene a little bit more organic. So you can also see it in the other shots. I added some camera shakes to these shots so I don't have to track anything later on in time, but I'm recording actually from a tripod. So yeah, that's it.
Alright, so that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like and definitely subscribe to the channel for more and hit the notification bell so you stay notified when I upload new videos. Also, check out our website. We have a lot of stuff to offer for any kind of digital creative. And if you buy something from our website, it really helps to support this channel. So that would be really, really awesome. Apart from that, I hope to see you boys and girls in the next one. Goodbye.